Hello, I'm Mr. R. Nitya, a retired lecturer in Madras preaching Christianity and Sikhism. Here I'm going to render exposition on Gnostic Gospel of Philip, translated by Wesley W. Eisenberg, part 62. Jesus appeared. There's something missing in Jordan, the fullness of the kingdom of heaven. Remember that the John the Baptist was in the Valley of Jordan. So John the Baptist was an ideal Levi priest, but because he was prophet Elijah, so he did not took the priestship of a certain congregation or parish, but all over. So he was teaching. He was not a preacher. He was a teacher of the moral laws. So he was teaching in the Valley of Jordan about the coming royal kingdom of God. And so he was keeping a law and order in the valley. So where there is law and order, we call it heaven. So the kingdom of heaven belonged to the Levi priest, as our John the Baptist was. So royal kingdom of God belongs to the sons of God, or Christ Jesus. Christ Jesus came to introduce to us the royal kingdom of God, whereas the kingdom of heaven was with John the Baptist, who was a teacher, and Jesus was a preacher, not a teacher. He was preacher of gospel that brings in the royal kingdom of God. He who was begotten before everything. So before everything, that means in the beginning was the God, and Word was with God. So that Word is called Christ. So that was the, he was in the beginning with the Father, was begotten anew. So he came in this dark age to make us like the royal king, people of the royal kingdom of God. So he came to sow the seed of or start the sons of God, which are called saint. In the kingdom of heaven, you have people who are perfect in moral laws. They are called angels. While in the royal kingdom of God, which belong to our Father God, we have saints, and saints are superior to the angels. So angels can make mistake, but saints do not make mistake. So whatever comes from their mouth is absolute truth. So he came to renew the bond, our bond with God, as it was in the beginning. He who was once anointed was anointed anew. So he was anointed once, he was anointed anew. Remember John the Baptist, when he baptized Christ Jesus, and he did it for the sake of a ritual, or for the sake of the other people, to teach them, other people, the lesson, what it stands for. And the lesson was taught when Holy Spirit in the heaven spoke, "This is my beloved Son, listen to him." So that means the sonship of was recognized when John baptized. That's anointing. Same was the people who were baptized in water by Abraham. By John the Baptist. They were baptized in the name of Abraham and not in the name of Father, Holy Spirit and Son and all that nonsense they are doing today. So he who was redeemed in turn redeemed others. So he being a person who was redeemed. So a person who is a physician or who is a doctor can make other people doctors. But if he himself is sick, then he cannot make other people healthy. So Christ Jesus himself was redeemed. So he came into this world to redeem others who were seeking to be redeemed, like Simeon. When Jesus visited the temple, he said, "My salvation, I have seen you, now let the servant go." So that's he came to redeem people. And those who were predestined, they were redeemed. Whose names were written in the book of our Father, they were redeemed. Indeed, one must utter a mystery. He was preaching in parables, in mystery. The Father of everything united with the Virgin who came down. So the Father of everything, that means, now, God is our Father who is of everything, and the Son is the ambassador, omnipotent, or representing our Father God. So he came down to marry the virgins. Remember that Christ Jesus produced 12 workers, one defected, and the 11, they were all solitary, and they were all virgins. The person who is not solitary and he is following some other person, he is not virgin but a prostitute. Because if you want to marry God, then you have to be solitary. So these solitary people, they enter into the bridal chamber. And that is the marriage of the Son with the Virgin. And a fire shone for him on that day. He brought in fire, Christ Jesus. So that fire was to bake us, to purify us. As gold is purified through fire, when the slag or the rubbish is taken away, same Christ Jesus has brought us fire into this world. So whosoever will enter into that fire, he will be purified. And only those people enter whose hearts are clean and who are longing or who has the will to do so. While there are others who just laugh when you speak the gospel truth, they laugh at you. Such as, you know, when I say not a single Jew or a Sikh or a Hindu died because they were never born, how can they die then? Only tribal self were born, tribal self are dead. So they laugh at me. So those people who are in the bridal chamber are those who are speaking the gospel truth, other people mock them. Therefore, he appeared in the great bridal chamber. Great bridal chamber means that he created this chamber, which was already in existence, but he induced to us, he showed us that chamber through which you enter into the royal kingdom of God. So Jesus took the workers and made them the mirror image of himself, which they could perceive themselves in the bridal chamber, which was lined with mirrors. So people, he made everybody like his own self. So when he has reproduced it, then he went back to his Father, that he has finished the job which was assigned to him on this earth. God bless you.